cab 1080s, and once again having trouble landing forwards, so he ended up landing fakie, and you know, brought around to a cab 1260, which was just something that a couple of years ago, unthought of. Shane Yost has come out this year and just brought it to a whole new level. The guys, you know, trained really hard, really focused. And out in Frankfurt this year, we had a ramp, you know, that allowed him to go for the forwards to forward 1260, which spinning fake is one thing, it's a little bit easier than spinning forwards, but a forward to forward 1260 is the most phenomenal trick ever. You know, unheard of, unthought of. Shane pulled it out, and now, you know, 4 weeks later, he's pulling it off left, right, and center, telling us that he's going to go for the, you know, 1420 or 1660 or whatever it is. I don't know, I'm losing count.
Spins first came about with a guy called Chris Edwards on vert. Vert skating is where sort of aggressive skating very first started to be noticed anyway. Like, there was guys out on the street, but people didn't really pay any attention to it until it actually got in the air. And Chris Edwards was the first one to do a big spin with a spin called a McTwist, and he'd do a style Japan McTwist, which still to this day people can't copy. It was one of the most amazing things I've ever seen.
I remember buying like Daily Bread number 2, the blue issue, way a long time ago, like on the front ramp. Like, everybody's just standing like this, Brooke, you can see with a wife beater. He's just like, and Judah Stell McTwist, oh, I was like, oh my God, you know, this can be done.
This year in vert, there's been quite a few kind of advances, if you'll call it that. Sessa, first of all, landing a fakie 1260 after his run, and then Shane Yost in Europe pulling a forwards 1260, which in my opinion is harder, but I'm a kind of skater who likes landing backwards, whereas Shane Yost likes landing forwards, so for him it's a lot easier. Well, I wouldn't call it easy at all, but
for me to land fakie is very hard. My knees are a little susceptible to certain knocks, and when I land fakie on my knees, it tends to hurt a lot, so I prefer not to land fakie. I prefer to land forwards. Plus, by landing forwards, I get to see where I am in relation to the rest of the ramp and what I have to do to alter, like what I have to do to land it. So for me, landing forwards is a lot easier, but a lot of guys out there like to land fakie because it feels a lot more natural and it feels easier. But for me, it's definitely forward.
Now it's to the point where, like, it's not enough just to have a huge vocabulary of tricks, you know, be able to do 540, 720, you know, all that stuff. You have to have a huge vocabulary of tricks both ways. I mean, it seems like every guy now, you have to go out and learn every trick both ways.
That was some of the big things this year in vert skating, in terms of spinning anyway.
Thanks, Scott. It seems like these tricks just keep evolving, evolving. Not only do you have to go big and spin more, but now there's different variations of spins. So when we get back to Fort Myers, Florida, we're going to take a look at corkscrews and flat spins.
Scotty, one of those guys, who do you think that we've seen do some alley-oop switch airs or any of this switch airs? I think Ty Chris.
Yeah, definitely. When he was in Europe, it was pretty
Sweden,
crazy.
Yeah, that was Sweden, pretty crazy. Yeah. Sweden. I saw him do a couple alley-oop airs. I think that just the thing that makes it more difficult is that you're not on your regular air, you know. It doesn't feel the same when you air this way than your switch, so.
Ty was going super high doing them, which again, I mean, it's hard enough to go high on a vert ramp as it is,
then
but
switch.
Let alone to go switch, which is one of the amazing things about Ty. He has the ability to actually do that. And in Sweden, we actually saw him pull that out in his runs.
You've got guys like Ty Chris and Matt Solana who are really taking the creative palette to a whole new level. They can't quite spin as many rotations as Shane and Sessa, but you've got a guy like Matt Solano who spins switch and regular so easily. I mean, you cannot tell which way is his regular spin, which is just incredible. And now Ty Chris is coming out. Not only is he spinning switch, but he's changing the axis of his spin, which is something that's really hard to do. If you look at Sessa and Shane, they can both spin amazing rotations, but they have trouble changing the axis of their spin. What I mean by that is Ty and Matt, they can twist, they can corkscrew, they can lay flat on any of their spins, which opens up their repertoire, you know, three times. which is just a skill that not many pro skaters have. Tiger's come out this year, he trained in France, and he's learnt the corkscrew 720, which is just a totally different looking 720. And then you got Matt Solano, who's just switching up every which way in his spin.
And also, like Chris, they sort of were the first ones to really make it a thing, like spinning both ways and making it look like both ways were natural.
I mean, it's a whole half of skating turning the other way.
Yeah.
You limit yourself by a half if you don't turn the other way.
From the crowd will look at it and they will not know any difference between a switch and a regular.
Switch and regular.
But the judges and all the skaters realize how hard it is. It is like riding with your left hand, you know. It's really hard.
That's basically very what hard. It is. I mean, if you spin this way, you just throw your body like this. This is the way you're comfortable. But imagine the same thing, but on the opposite way. So that's what makes the truth. I mean, anything that switch or true spin is kind of, you know, difficult. Extremely difficult, and you get much more points on the judging side, you know.
Rollerblading is the best.
Style. Not really too much that you can do about style. It's pretty much just the way you learn how to skate and the way you can skate and the way you put out your feelings towards skating and stuff.
I guess that's where style comes from. It's the way how you do it. You know, it's, I don't really think about, you know, I got, you know, look like this when I do this trick. You know, it's more like you gotta be able to do it first, you know.
Like the trend is to be like the hip hop thing, you know what I mean? Like so many people are just like, you know, I gotta do it like this and that. Like a lot of kids out there will look up to their skater, like, I don't wanna say any names. Well, I don't know. Like, you know, there's a lot of Dustins out there. There's a lot of John Julios and Josh Pettys, like kids that just analyze what they do to like the very hand stroke, you know what I mean? And it's cool, you know, whatever they wanna do, it's cool. But like, you know, you should take the initiative and do something. And who cares, you know what I mean? Like, because it's so obvious, like, you know, watching a kid and they do something identical to what they do, because it's like, dude, you know, you can be yourself and it wouldn't matter just as long as it feels good, you know?
It's all about individuality. I mean, when you put skates on and how you skate and how you do grinds and stuff like that, that's your style. That's exactly what style is how you see rollerblading. I mean, how I go to sleep at night and how I see that is how I want myself to be portrayed. Like, that's how I want to be able to do a trick. And I don't think if I do a trick, I won't do it till I see that it's right in my mind. Like, I won't do it, I won't say I've done it until I've done it right in my mind. And that's style, and that's my style.
One skater has made a huge name for himself in the sport by going super huge with nice style. It's Jonathan Bergeron.
I'm here now with John Bergeron. John has an interesting hobby that's actually paying off. He's coming out with his own rap CD. He's going to be featured in one of my videos. He's all that pretty good. He freestyles a lot. Goes out to clubs. I've seen him jump on stage with people before and get down.
You know my game. Everything is all the same when I drop the fame. You know my name. John B. coming at you for free. You ain't painting the fee for us to see me defeat every MC on concrete from Montreal to NYC. What you want to peep is a nice at three, not a caddy. And SWV is the type of lady that I get groovy. Up in VIP. Damn, I feel it.
Hey, you want me to try out? I want to be on the CD. All right, John B, kicking it for you here. All right. ASA.
Hey, don't go anywhere. I bet we'll be right back.
Maki Komori, they really focused on being in sync. Timing was everything, but they actually threw some difficult tricks.
We put together the best run in all of Triple's history.
Well, you're a little bit over the top there, John, but we'll go with it. You definitely had the most entertaining run. These guys know how to have fun. And watch your eye.
Lightsabers and all. Eitan, Manuel, and Scott Crawford, all very talented skaters. Give them too much, and they really skate horribly. The Triples, just a time to have some fun and get the crowd into it.
You heard it from Mark Chase.
These guys, Matt Salerno, Cesar Mora, Mike Budnick, three of the most consistent skaters in the world, They had some fun linking some tricks and throwing some difficult spins. Cesar Mora at 1080 in the middle.
Ty, Javier, and Sven. Those are three names you don't want to hear when you're competing. These guys had the most technical run and won first place, as a matter of fact. Check this out.
All those difficult tricks we were talking about, they threw all of them. Gato spins, eggplant McTwists, 900s, the works. A well-deserved triples victory.
You want to talk about creativity? This guy right here invented creativity. Look at that.
Blake Dennis spinning to win and then up through the rhythm section, completely faking the whole. One thing that adds difficulty to a trick is style, believe it or not. Matt Salerno just tweaking everything around the course. Nice top soles, soles up on the sub box. He had a lot of difficult tricks.
I mean, there's only so much you can say about Aaron Feinberg. This guy has every trick in the book. He's very smooth and he is not afraid of anything.
But the X Games streak belonged to Nicky Adams. So many difficult tricks this guy pulls, all looking super good. Nicky Adams at only 16 years old, the second Canadian to win on street.
And back over on vert, Chris Edwards shows some of his signature tricks.
Cesar Mora took it to the coping a bit more than he has in most competitions.
And if one Australian isn't enough, here's another one. Matt Salerno spinning his way to the top.
But the king of the day, Eito Yasutoko, who mixed it up on the coping and went huge with his 540 and 720 flat spins. Some new tricks unveiled at the X Games and some new champions as well.
Got a guy like Eito Yasutoko, who a couple of years ago came up with the flat spin. People were just amazed at what this was.
When it comes to flat spins, it was a trick that really just started last year, and people like Javier and Tig and a lot of Europeans started doing them, and then it worked its way over to the States, and now you've got people like Shane and Ty Chris who are doing flat spin 900s, and even if it doesn't look as clean as say one of Cessa's 720s, it's still, they've only been doing it for a couple of months, and with time it's definitely the future of spinning.
Ty Chris, I think he was the first guy to do it on vert.
There was actually he actually learned it off a little kid in Europe, like a 14-year-old kid in Europe.
Tobias?
I think it was Tobias. Yeah. Tobias? Like, yeah, Tom Fry went to Europe after he learned them over a spine, and showed Tobias how to do them, and he was actually the first one to land one on vert. That's my understanding of it anyway.
When we come back, we're gonna shift gears to the street and one of the world's most respected skaters, Eric Schrein.
I used to look up to Eric Schrein a lot, and I met him and I got to meet him. He was a nice guy and I liked him. We got to become best friends, and everywhere we went, and like I started traveling with him everywhere I went, he always represented for Rollerblading, and he always made it so that like he had a good time there, and he could tell he was a good time, and everywhere he went he just made it so that he represented for Rollerblading, like showing skating in a kind of an untouchable form. He always did some crazy stuff. The guy's been around for a long time and I respect what he's been doing and I hope he keeps doing it.
Eric Schrein is the most respected street skater, or one of the most respected. Unbelievable.
He's really well respected on all around the world. All the skaters know him. Eric Schrein is just a cool person himself. You know, you'll see him if you check him out on his profile. He's just a great guy. He's cool as hell.
As soon as I started grinding, I was like, man, this is it. This is what I want to do. I guess the thing that makes me stick with it is just that, just the feeling of when you put your mind to something, like a certain grind, a gap, whatever, and like you know it's difficult and you keep trying it and you fall and you keep trying it and keep trying it, but just the feeling that you get when you pull it you know, to the point where you can't pull in any better, you like do it any better. It's just like, it's a rush, and like, I don't know, it's just a feeling that, I don't know, that you can't explain. It's just so good.
Eric's the dopest. He's really dedicated, so that's what makes him cool, and he never gives up. That's what I like about him.
If you're known as to like people as like a good person, then that would be like a good way of success, you know? Because it's like, dude, you know, you can be yourself, and it wouldn't matter just as long as it feels good, you know?
He's the type of guy that'll do anything for anyone. Like, you know, he'll go out of his way to like, you know, hook up a kid for wheels or clothes, you know? Or skates if he can, you know, like whatever he can get that he doesn't need, he'll be the person to like give it away, you know. He's just there for everyone. He's an awesome person.
Picture my dad when right before he went to Vietnam. He's always been there and helped me out through every like little thing that I need to do, and he's always got my back.
All the stuff he does, I can't do. You know, I'm blind now. I've been in the war in Vietnam, and you know, gotten disease when hepatitis and got blind. He's a world traveler, and he's doing good at what he does. He's a top 10 skater. I'm very proud of him, and he's confident with, you know, with himself with that.
You know, you can't be arrogant about it if you're good. You know, they raised me just to, you know, be humble about what you do. You know, have respect for yourself and everyone else. Future for Eric Trine. I'm gonna start junior college in next fall in cinematography, because I can't skate forever, so I wanna, you know, kind of do something that has to do with the industry, you know, bring something back to it, and I wanna film, and I'm really into it. So it's like the ultimate sports filmer or director, whatever goes, you know, as long as I'm on my feet.
Okay, Flip started out from launch ramp, which is where a lot of you probably started out off launch ramps. I know I started out skating street on launch ramps before we actually started riding vert. And it was just one of those things that people started doing, you know. Chris Edwards was front flipping off jump ramps over cars, you know, into the street and things like that. And it kind of all started and got going, and then it was really hard to make a front somersault look cool. So it got right into just spinning 360s, 540s, 720s for a long time.
And then when Tom Fry started taking the 360s and started changing the axis on that, started getting more and more bio on it, I think he was inspired actually originally by motocross when they get sideways on the airs.
Yeah, definitely.
So when Tom started doing that and the flat spins, it took the aesthetic that we were all used to in rollerblading. You could do grabs and it looked cool, you know, you could give it style. Yeah. And so then flat spins started, as they got more and more inverted and people got more and more exaggerated with them, and guys like Bergeron, who really, I think, sort of took flat spins to the next level. Jaron Grobe, but I'm talking about like 2 years ago, Bergeron, you know, his Liu Kang flat spin became his trademark, you know?
Yeah.
And so then that made the transition to where flips started coming back into style, but not just because they're flips, but because they looked like rollerblading. People were doing grabs in them and doing 540s and 720s that looked cool. And then as it got more and more inverted, eventually these guys basically were doing backflip. Hey, Bruno, what's up? Guys like Bruno doing backflip 180s.
Rollerblading had its individuality back again, you know. It wasn't related to gymnastics in any way because they didn't do it.
So we came to it by our own
exactly. It was an individual thing that rollerbladers made a point of doing themselves. It wasn't a go to a coach and learn how to do a flip into a foam pit, you know. It was a pure thing. I think that's the other thing it was.
When it comes to the actual street skating, people like Sven Bokhorst and Aaron Feinberg will always be amazing to watch. When you watch Sven skate, he makes tricks look so easy that if anyone out here, even all the pros went out there and tried, they'd fall like
probably.
Aaron, his whole mindset about skating is unbelievable. He doesn't allow himself to become afraid of a trick. He sees something, if he feels that he could do it, he just does it. And knowing that, it's just unbelievable to watch.
When we come back, we're gonna count down the best tricks of the year.
In the way she never looks my way, I'm in love. Something in the way she doesn't hear a word I say, I'm in love. But people say we're not.
yeah, the tricks now are just getting so technical, it's unbelievable. Because then Feinberg jumped up to Sol and then actually 270 to 360 into the transition as well. So, I mean, people now are not just doing one trick, linking. Like, you have to disaster off this and then spin into that and then over hop wall ride to grind this. You know, you can't just do a single trick anymore.
I know.
A soul grind doesn't count anymore. You've got to do this to a soul or that. Because
if you see just the grind, normal grind, if you just go and just soul and just come down, it's like, all right, it's a soul. Yeah. You know, it's a soul. But nowadays, like, even, I don't know if you've seen the rail on the top, like, you can grind that and then jump into the tranny. Something that Feinberg's kind of, he does that a lot.
He is the leader
like,
of that.
Like, Feinberg is the leader of that. He'll always find, like, a rail on a gap and then just drop in. You know, things like that, it's just like connecting. It's like a combo, you know.
On street skating, one of the biggest trends is a thing called the true spin, where people are spinning. There's different ways you can spin to a rail. If you're spinning, if the rail's on your left and you spin to your left, you're going to be able to visualize the rail. You're going to be able to see the rail as you're spinning. So when you're spinning up, you can watch the rail the whole time and it never goes out of your line of sight. A true spin is when you do the same exact trick, but you spin the other way to it. So if the rail's on your left, you would spin to your right. That way the rail would be behind you and you completely lose sight of the rail. So you have to spot the rail, spin to your right, lose sight of the rail, and as you're coming around, try to see the rail again and lock on. And there's literally only a split second there where you finally see the rail and you've got to put your foot on. When you've got people like Dustin and John Julio and Blake Dennis like transferring to it and doing it down really gnarly handrails, I mean, no one can really comprehend how hard that is.
There's some style and creativity. Oh, from John Julio, 360 to wall ride. Again, bringing the real street back into it with Bruno. Well, I remember John Julio at...
We can't forget King Julio.
King Julio. At Salt Lake City doing the 360 over the rail.
It was like from the deck where the judges were standing. What I liked about that is how Julio mixes it up with his own street steez to the street course. So every time he will go and do that stuff, you know, it looks like he's skating street on a street course.
I know,
that makes
which
it
is
awesome.
I think it's amazing how quickly the vocabulary and the difficulty goes from the streets, you know, where kids are doing it out on the streets and doing it in videos, and then how it comes into something that's running competition. I mean, to talk, you know, it's one thing to go out and shoot it for a video and, you know, you can have like 10, 20 attempts and the tricks are so hard. But now these guys are doing these tricks that are so incredible, you know, true spin alley-oop soyal or true spin topside alley-oop soyal or full cabbing into true spin topside stuff. I mean, these are things they're landing on their first try in the middle of the competition, no less. It's amazing.
Yeah, now at Louisville, Blake Dennis did the disaster true spin alley-oop topside salt.
Topside salt.
And,
far side, like,
In his run. It wasn't after, it was actually in his run, which is unbelievable. That's one of my favorite things of the whole year I've seen.
I just gotta give it up for him because it's really technical. It's
very,
kinda hard.
Very technical.
And you know, especially on your run, you know, on your run and a true spin too. It's like,
I know.
Boom, what the hell is he thinking?
I know, it's very hard to explain the actual technicality of that trick and the actual to actually get over the fear of trying it for the first time.
I know.
That's a scary trick to try.
Well, here's six of the best tricks throughout the year as chosen by the skaters. Jaron Grove doing huge 720s up on the wall.
How about 8-toes flat spin 720?
Sean Robertson every week tried a different variation of a nose pick 540.
And of course, you've got Sasamora pulling the 1260.
This one was fakey, but Shane Yost tried it frontwards.
And what makes it amazing, Mark, is that he landed it his first try.
And with only 15 seconds left in his run, you can't forget this one, Blake Dennis. This is the trick that got him to the X Games. ASA World Championship Weekend and winter home of Thomas Edison.
Mark, I bet you didn't know this. Thomas Edison registered over 1,900 patents on his inventions. One of which was the light bulb, which makes it a lot easier for us to skate at night. Thanks a lot, Tom.
Of course, the vert competition took place at night, and World Championships weekend actually was the culmination of 9 different events, plus diversity and all of the breakdancing. And of course, the way it ended was on a huge note, the best trick competition.
That's right, after the vert finals, Mark, they turned this half pipe into one big trick contest fun box. a 20-foot launch, a gap over that, and the rest of the half pipe to go off.
An event like this, I think, I mean, every year it should be the one that beats the regular season events. I mean, and just makes the whole year, you know, I want it to bring back memories from the whole prior year, and it does that. You know, everyone comes together. You have all the AMs here. You have everybody hanging out together, and it's good, man. It's good for all of us to see what's coming up, and for the AMs to see what's happening on the big scene. And I like it. You know, it's good to end the year like this.
And this is how it works. We have 15 competitors. They each get 3 attempts to land the best trick that they can do, judged by a panel of 8, and they win a whopping $5,000.
Notably, Sean Robertson, this guy always goes big. Of course, Chris Edwards, Bergeron, Matt Salerno, Joe Ackler, who won last year's Best Trick of the Year, and this guy, Matt Lindenmuth, the number one ranked skater of 1998 on Vert. And Brian, you're going to see these guys do a lot of setup airs just to make sure they have exactly the right pump.
They're trying some of the hardest tricks done in a rollerblading mark, so they do have to make sure they take off. Like, he's traveling over that gap, so if he doesn't set up and take off at the right point, it could mean disaster. See how close he came?
900 degree spin. Didn't nail it, landed a little bit low, but he gets 2 more attempts. Sean Robertson does so many different types of tricks.
Sean can hurl his body up to the air like a cat and always land on his feet. Look at that, huge backflip. Very nice.
Backflip traveled 12 feet across the gap. Just imagine if you're, say, 6 inches short.
I am, Mark.
Up next, Chris Edwards. Chris is a vert dog, but every year he goes huge off the launch box. There, going for a 900.
Ooh, he'll feel that one in the morning.
Going down super hard. He tried it 2 different times each attempt, falling hard.
Do you know what's amazing about that, Mark? It's 22 feet long, and he landed in the middle of the transition. That guy was moving.
A good 30-foot, 900-degree rotation, but he didn't land on his feet.
Ooh! Ah! Ooh! Oh. Shane Saviors going down big. Try to topside Elliot Soul. That's almost blind. That took guts. I think I see his guts, actually.
Shane Saviors trying to get technical. You have to be exactly on. His back foot falls off. He then tries to catch himself and boom, right here hits his head.
Maybe he was going for some kind of gymnastics move. I don't know.
He does get 2 more attempts. Shane Saviors, big cojones. Jake Elliott, super creative. He tries different things.
That's called an acid drop, ladies and gentlemen. That's a big drop. Notice the impact. Boom, you just crush.
Not able to stay on his feet because he didn't have a down ramp to roll down on. Jonathan Bergeron, the Bergenator, getting super technical. He's been trying this in warm-ups.
Ooh, alley-oop wall ride, 270 to Seoul. He almost locked on, just missing a little bit.
The trick there, you have to nail the heel on the coping. If you don't do it, then you're not really hitting the sole.
This scares me. Salerno looking big. Oh my, what a big drop that was. And he's going to feel that one on his knees. Look at that, off the extension, way down. You got to land on the transition on the top if you're going to make that one, Matt.
If you get too close to the platform, you're going to hang your toes up and pummel your head into the flat bottom. If you pull out too far like you did, there's no way to land it.
Joe Ackler up next. This guy has come on the scene, Mark, and he's really been impressing a lot of people. He's incredibly technical. Let's see what he's got up his sleeve for us. A little setup there, getting ready.
2 setups, it's gotta feel the pump right. He likes to do disaster to grinds.
Oh, that would have been the most difficult trick I ever saw. It was a 540, the topside alley-oop sole true spin. Look at that. He almost pulled that off. If he was in the ramp a little more, he would have done it. That would have just set it off right there.
Joe Ackler gets another try. Up next, 13 years old, Takeshi Yasutoko, the youngest pro on the tour. And this kid has become so talented that he's virtually fearless.
It's amazing how these little guys just wind up and go. Let's see what he's going to pull here. He's going over the gap. Nice frontside Royale, and he really locked out of that one, but It is lacking a little bit of difficulty. He's going to have to pull something like a variation if he wants to keep up with the rest of these guys. Look at that, though. If you miss, it's Yaoi.
Last year, he tried the soul grind over and over, wasn't able to pull it all the way. This time, at least he clears it. Shane Xavier's going back for more. Frontside torque, that's a lot more difficult than the Royale.
I'd say, Mark, that this is probably the most difficult trick I've seen so far. That is a perfect torque slide right over the gap, right in the transition. Good control and good style.
I guess when you're competing for $5,000, the pain disappears pretty quick.
I don't feel a thing.
Jeremy Panichini over the box.
Oh,
going for a 1080.
Bio at that, Mark.
Bio throwing his feet up even to his head, but he goes down hard.
It looks smooth, but I tell you what, I've been out there and that landing hurts because it stretches your skin. You can see in his face there, he's hurting, but you got to go on.
And on we will go with Nicky Adams, Joe Ackler, and Shane Yost.
We are talking now with Nicky Adams, and if you notice, I'm squinting a little bit because of all the shininess off his gold. Nicky, you're really into the gold thing now, right?
Yeah, I like gold a lot. You know, it builds my personality, my style, and you know, that's just how it is. Makes me floss, you know. Blau, that's Nicky Adams. Look at that, look at that. Oh God, I can't see him.
Blau, right now, Shane Saviors is the man looking at the gold, but Nicky Adams would love to take it. Before the competition, he was sitting there going, what do I have to do to win? That's all he really wants.
Whoa, 900. Forward 900, that'll do it. Oh, let me translate for you, Mark. What? Oh, y'all, what? He's a little upset. He didn't land that last year, but look how perfect it is this year. Spotted the landing and landed perfect. He is now in first place.
Nicky Adams just lacing the 22-foot box. That's right. Show me the money.
I want my money. Well, this guy can take it away. Shane Yost up next. Don't ever count him out of a competition, Mark. He is going for something big.
What? 900 flat spin. You know what? I think the gold just got taken away from Nicky Adams.
Wow. Shane Yost just yousted Nicky. It's just all coming down to this, Mark. Who's got the bigger trick? Look at that. 900 and also landed it perfect. Very excited. And if you remember, last year, John Bergeron won with a 720 flat spin. And this year, Shane does a 900.
This is kind of like an invitational for all the pros. You know, it's only like the top 28 or something like that. So basically all the best in the world this time are going to be here. It's not just like maybe half or a third like some of the other events. So, you know, and it always turns out to be the best skating because, you know, it's better and better as the whole competition goes along. And by the end of the whole weekend, everyone's just like going crazy, you know. So it puts a lot of pressure on some people who are expected to do good. But, you know, it's also a chance for people who aren't that well known that qualified for this to do good. So hopefully I do good.
Well, Joe Ackler made his mark last year by winning best trick of the year. He didn't win the best trick competition, but throughout the season nailed one of the best. This is gonna be a war between going big and being super technical.
I tell you what, he just won that. There is no way anyone can top that. That was like an alley-oop, actually 450. Let's see here. That's right, 450 to alley-oop, so 180 out. That was absolutely sick.
Joe Ackler busting out. You have to be so precise because you have to nail the spin all the way over the gap and then boom, hit the exact spot on the side of the boot.
You gotta be nuts is what you gotta be. He doesn't even believe it. But you better believe one thing, that guy right there, Joe Ackler, just took home $5,000. Nicky Adams pulled the 900 off the box, then he got knocked out by Shane Yost with 900 flat spin, and Joe Ackler takes home the big $5,000 with the 450 to alley-oop sole.
I don't know, I'm not a competition skater. I'm like a one-trick kind of guy, you know. I can't believe I won. I'm happy. I still can't believe I won. It's awesome.
Well, you better believe it. You're walking home with $5,000. Joe Ackler, a true champion. When we come back, we're going to take it to the real streets. Pro Tour's Best Tricks 99 is brought to you by Naya Pure Spring Water. Hungry for life, thirsty for Naya. by ASASkate.com. For all the latest on skating, check out ASASkate.com. Feed your habit. And by the city of Fort Myers, the city of palms. My heart.